doctor, ¿sabes eso?
You know the place.
Okay, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This is the last session. I guess that everybody has his or her head filled up with data. Sorry? It works.
He's taller than the average.
I have to do it like this then. Is that better? Okay. So this is the last session. Everybody's filled up with a lot of new ideas and so on. And this is also a very difficult sort of session, because we have had many presentations. We want to draw some lessons to see what do we get out of this. But I, from my own experience, I think sometimes that is useful to have this sort of sessions. What are the sort of main lines? What do we get from this? What do we learn from it? And for that, we had a surprise, and we got some eminent scholars, researchers in this field to have their light shine on a couple of comments that I make on like an overview of what has all transpired in this conference. So the setup is as this. Our panel members are Jerome Blanc, Thomas Grego, and Makoto Mishibe. I will only give a sort of commentary based on the reports that were assembled by the rapporteurs that are listed here as well, because I also can't be in 40 sessions at the same time. And then after that commentary, I will ask the eminent scholars to comment. And then we could have some final dialogue with the public. And after that, Georgina will do the formal closure together with Leander and Eric. That is the sort of setup of this this closing session. This is an academic conference, 2 days, 40 papers. One was not presented. With a tremendous variety on the subject matter of CCS. Often we talk about CCS, but there has been a tremendous variety in LETs, time banks, mutual credit, cash-based, cashless, public, private. There's a tremendous variety in the subject matter. There has been also this variety in the dimensions considered, either in multidisciplinary or single-disciplinary approaches. Sometimes community currencies are subsumed as part of a larger discourse. It's like Catherine was saying, CCS needs a home, and therefore as part of a larger discourse. And in other instances, paper seeks to formulate theories about CCS itself. Yeah? CCS sometimes is a means to achieve other ends, buy local, regenerate economy, provide services, alleviate poverty, environmental programs. But other studies focus directly on the transformative power of CCS itself. What I found a relatively new dimension is that there is now much more attention to state and social policies and the importance of tax and regulatory and financial regulation and CCS as a topic. There has been a tremendous disciplinary variety in these 2 days. Geographers, anthropologists, political scientists, psychologists, designers, economists of different orientations. There's been a tremendous variety. There's also been a big variety in the context of CCS, be it geographically or institutionally isolated systems, like refugee camps as an application, to large urban centers. And there has been a variety also in the level of sophistication of the various papers, from very scholarly top-level papers to basic descriptive narratives. So if the work of CCS itself is experimental and in need of acquiring new competences, that I think also applies to the research. It needs, with all these varieties that we have seen, it needs some consolidation while at the same time reframing the issues, which indeed is one of the most exciting thing that I found from the conference. But there are important continental differences. What struck me is that the Japanese and Korean researchers, not all, but many of them, had a strong focus on awareness and motivation to participate in CCS and look at the psychological effects on users. While the Western researchers were focusing very much on how to design the systems and how to make CCS work. It's like sometimes we say, the wisdom comes from the East, in terms of the humankind and humanity and the human mind, and the Westerners are tinkering on making it better. And that sort of gap or difference is also emerging in the papers that we saw. Then Latin Americans, when I talk to some of them, they say, well, they see really that in Europe the CCS is really becoming something of an alternative, something that is really different from the mainstream economy. While they struggle with complementarity as a means of survival within the mainstream economy, within the economy. So there are sort of interesting differences. I don't know why, but I guess that also something that in the beginning, certainly by Catherine, was also asked for, that is, we do what the Japanese do, that is, study more also the sort of psychological aspect of the role of CCS in the people that are participating in it. CCS is not just about issuing money. That is, I think, something very clear in many presentations. It's a whole community-based, often grassroots program. But furthermore, we now have the national tax authorities and financial regulators that are not so much interested in the social aspects, but they're interested in legal and financial conditions. And what does it mean, the currency systems, for in terms of taxation? And local authorities that have come in strongly using CCS as a means of social policies, they also have very different concerns. They speak also a very different language. And for me, the question then is, are the researchers and the practitioners, can they speak these different languages? Can they do that? Or do we really need some sort of cooperation and have some sort of division of labor where different people focus on different things but are in clear interaction with each other. Then the organizers, they had asked the reporters to comment on three items. We can't cover everything in this closing session. They ask, what is innovative in the papers? Conceptually, empirically, methodologically. What's new? What do the papers say about the viability of CCS? And what does it say about sustainable and local development impact? Those are the sort of three questions that the organizers are interested in. It's clearly also issues that are nowadays living among very many researchers. So what's our harvest in these questions? And of course, I make now these comments, but I am a relatively outsider. I wasn't in Lyon, and actually, I'm not an expert. I don't claim to be an expert on CCS. I leave that to my colleague, Georgina. So first of all, in terms of the innovative thinking, I think there was a lot about innovative thinking about money, particularly this whole debate about plurality and unicity or unicity of money. We got very interesting contributions in these 2 days. We got evidence from history about the importance of plurality, both in ancient history in different parts of the world, as well as in more recent times, like in a paper on monetary federalism in Argentina. Also, there are important new debates are reviving economic literature on this question of homogeneity or heterogeneity with regard to money. And very good reviews about the history of economic schools of thought that show that there was initially a focus on plurality, going to unicity and then ending again in plurality. And the question is, new question is plurality a pathology or a virtue? So it's not anymore a question of one versus the other, but what are the benefits or the problems with plurality? It's something that one could start from multi-currency scenarios rather than arguing the case for plurality. There are also interesting physics approach to plurality that used physics theories, entropy or chaos theory, that showed the trade-off between issues of efficiency and diversity, and argues that CCS may be less efficient, but it is more sustainable and resilient. And other contributions reframed, indeed, CCS conceptualizations using Polanyi or Harding, or sought to conceptualize about articulation of different systems, unpacking the notion of complementarity using a more institutionalist approach. Other innovations in terms of conceptualizing CCS is research that has drawn on innovation theory, conceptualizing CCS as an information niche, which argues that grassroots needs are crucial for a good takeoff of CCS. And begins to find also these comparative findings that I think are very important given the proliferation of different types of CCS that we are talking about, is
one of the contributions. Other contributions, we saw various contributions on this issue of perceptions, awareness, CC consciousness.
CC consciousness of users and volunteers. These are clearly new contributions from psychology, but also look at the effect of these psychological effects on the viability of the CCS. So that's definitely interesting new work. There's also new innovative work. I was very impressed with the work in Kenya about urban CCS, which has a very strong evaluation component, where control groups are used, where baselines are identified, where it's identified what is the scope for using the complementary currency as a complementary unit in terms of sales of small businesses. So that's indeed very, very interesting experimental work that definitely builds on new competences for CCS researchers. There is also interesting papers about new electronic forms, e-money and payment institutions, and game modeling to examine the impact of smart cards and networks of users. There are beginnings of an evolutionary approaches to CCS development. Is there a life cycle? Is there a life cycle of in CCS development? Because we see in many cases the argument has been mostly that CCS is anti-cyclical, but now people are beginning to develop and see different things. It's not necessarily an anti-cyclical matter, but that it's also a matter where there is a question of learning, acquiring, achieving the objective, and then looking for new ways to deploy them. And that's really where the CCS becomes a transformative power for different purposes. But here, the sort of evolutionary approaches are very interesting. There is new thinking about non-financial dimensions. In fact, there has been an enormous amount, and it's impossible to summarize that in a few words. This notion of the DOC as an institution in Japan, the power time case is a very complex program that has been gradually built up. In fact, there is a tremendous reframing of CCS in the various papers. But this also calls for sharper definitions and typologies of CCS. I think that is if we want to, we should not get caught only in reframing, but also consolidating. That was the point that I made earlier. Innovations in terms of researching the impact on sustainable and local development. There we found a range of topics. CCS and business development in Brazil and Kenya. CCS and economic regeneration in depopulated areas in Korea, Japan. CCS and social and environmental services in UK and Kenya. CCS and labor markets, differentiating a very interesting way between short-term and long-term unemployed and its effect on CCS use. And then CCS with different logics that was presented this morning in different countries. Also there, I think there is an uneven development of methodologies, yeah, where outcomes are more or less rigorously evaluated. And I see here a sort of a parallel with another area in which I'm quite familiar, that is decentralization research. I see quite a parallel that also there we had initially a focus on quantitative indicators, fiscal indicators. And gradually people began to see that decentralization actually has many more dimensions. How to measure them, but then become what kind of indicators make sense. And what you then see in the last few years is that people try to replicate studies so that there is a comparative element over time, what's happening, but at the same time they add on new elements in terms of methodological innovations. And I think that is the sort of road that we also would have to go in terms of CCS research. There was an interesting paper on innovative advances promoting this evaluation matrix, trying to formulate theories of change. This is something that in evaluation research is now becoming a standard. I mean, if we want to examine impact, we have to have a theory of change. That's a standard in a lot of evaluation research. And I see now already a first development, experimental development in this area that was presented this afternoon. What type of CC system is more viable and what factors undermine or strengthen viability? Which are the ones that draw attention of regulators? How are CCS managed and what make them more effective? This is this kind of research that I mentioned that a lot of the Western researchers are focused on. But the field is now becoming much broader. There are many more applications. We saw interesting cases of CCS in refugee camps or in isolated regions, the Bristol Pound and Time Banks in the UK. But more comparative research is needed about what works in what sort of circumstances and for what type of CCS. In terms of impact on sustainable development, we had this very interesting studies on the UK Time Banks, debunking some of the myth that are associated with the rise of the time banking industry. Very interesting study that also uses a realist evaluation framework. So this is also one where one begins to adopt the practices in terms of evaluation that are also used in other fields of social sciences. We had various papers on the dynamics of CCS in Brazil, which is an interesting new development. The Banco Palmas and other schemes that were discussed, where we saw this evolution of the use of CCS and the question being raised, how to keep it attractive by developing new objectives in social terms. Yeah. Other studies also report effects, but have less well elaborated technology methodologies in terms of how they actually did it, how did they define it, and can you really deal with these questions of attribution. Then the final remark that I have, which is a kind of reflection on the fishbowl. And the fishbowl had a lot of electric energy here. It was really very exciting. But it also reaffirmed to me this enormous variety, questioning historic evidence, practice-oriented questions, theory concerns, methodology, data, but also still a lot of normative positioning. And I think for researchers, we actually have to go back to the real questions in terms of theory more than on theoretical or normative positioning. Rephrasing, yes, but my question this morning was, have we understood each other's existing scripts? Do we understand the game modelers? Do we understand the social psychologist when he talks about it? Do we understand the political scientist and the economist? That is something that is still important. Finally, yes, there is clearly a community of practice, but I think there is still a need for more ordering of practices in which we are engaged. That was my comment. Thank you very much.